Vinventions is a total global closure solutions company, right? So at this site here in Zebulon, we make plant cork. Currently we do about 700 million plant corks per year. We do about 3 million per day. And right now we're currently a 24/5 operation. We do have a skeleton crew for the weekends. This site used to supply the global market, but now it's primarily focused on selling corks to the US market. We started in 1999. We've expanded probably two or three times, and it's grown into what you see today. We like to show off the plant. The first thing hopefully that you notice on this tour is that we really believe in visual management. You're about to enter at what we call our CVO6 area. This particular cell supplies Trinchero. So Trinchero, Sutter Home. We do roughly about 80 to 90 million closures a year for them.
Okay.
This is the main production area right here. This is our extrusion process. We use a co-extrusion process. So we extrude an inner layer of the cork, the foam, and then we extrude the outer layer of the cork, the skin. That extrusion is happening at the same time. It's all combined into this crosshead here. And as you see, you'll see the rod come out. And it's going to be a continuous rod. And really, all we do from this step on is try to cool that rod down. We're cooling the rod down with cooling water. This water is 100% recycled. And then the diameter of the cork is precisely controlled with this laser gauge here. 100% of the time, they know the exact diameter of the cork based on our laser micrometer. So after the first water bath, we're measuring the diameter, and then again, we're constantly cooling the cork down, this time with a spray. Again, the water's recycled, and then we use X-ray technology to have precise measurements of the skin. So what you see here is an X-ray gauge that's giving us continuous measurement. Again, the diameter is precisely controlled. Quality is super important to us. So this system is set up to automatically scrap corks that don't meet our diameter spec. For example, I'm just gonna trick the gauge for a second. So you see, because it detected that the diameter was too large. So it makes it very difficult for us to make poor quality. So again, the corks are cut to precise lengths and then stored in a tote. After the corks are extruded, the next step is to add a logo to the cork. So we have our printing step here. And what you'll notice, it's an offset printing step. We actually have a UV curable ink. The cork is corona treated, which is that electrical charge you see there. And then we have a printing plate, which allows us to print any type of logo on the cork. So that corona basically activates the surface of the cork. If you didn't have the corona, the ink would not stick to the cork. So after the corks are printed, the next step is to apply a silicone treatment. So the corks are actually loaded into that station there, blown up to that silicone treatment drum. They're treated with silicone. After silicone treatment, the corks are counted out in batches of 1,000. They're bagged, put into a box, and then they're off really to be palletized and shipped to the warehouse. So this is the warehouse. So really, once the product is extruded, printed, treated, packed, it comes in here. Each one of these rows that you see, each one of these lanes, is a full production order that's about to be shipped. So again, it's very, very neat, very organized. And if it's back here, it means it's an order that's ready to ship. This is the quality lab, probably the most important step in the process. Here we have two quality technicians. They're responsible checking incoming raw materials. They're responsible for doing process audits, and also they're responsible for making sure that the outgoing product is good. And so what you see in here, we go through a simulation of how a real bottling line would work. So we cork the bottles, we make sure there's no plunger marks or anything that would indicate low silicone. And then they would actually do a extraction force test, where the whole goal is to pull the cork out to make sure that it doesn't take too much force. Also, we have very tight control of all the dimensions of the cork. So this automated gauge is measuring the diameter, the cut length, the weight, the density. It can do moisture. And this was another continuous improvement idea because it allows our technicians to do other things while this thing is measuring for them. We can engineer a solution that's perfect, right? So regardless of the bottle, we can change the diameter. We can tailor that cork to be perfectly designed for that wine bottle. We can also, from a technology standpoint, we can change the oxygen transmission rate so that it's perfectly designed for whatever type of wine the winemaker wants to use. So you can't do that with a natural cork. You know, with natural cork, you get what you get. It's a great closure, but with the plant cork, we can tailor the OTR, oxygen transmission rate, to whatever we need it to be. In the US, I think we have 80% market share. And globally, I think we do 1 in 7 bottles of wine. It's closed with a cork from Vinventions. It's quite a few locations. We have 3 extrusion locations, one here in Zebulon, North Carolina. We have one in Temister, Belgium. And we have one in Argentina. And then we also have different sites that do different types of closures, like screw cap is in Italy. But we also do natural closures, which is in Germany. This is Zebulon's best kept secret, right? Because what happens, you know, you say, well, there's this global wine closure company, and it's hidden right here in Zebulon, North Carolina. And so that's what makes it pretty awesome, right? So we have these winemakers from all over the world. They come in and they say, well, where am I going? Well, I'm going to Zebulon, North Carolina, right? So that makes it pretty cool. The secret to this plant is really the people, right? You may hear a lot of people say that, but in this plant, we truly believe in continuous improvement. And continuous improvement doesn't just come from people like me, managers or engineers. It comes from every single employee that's out there doing the work. Because if it's good for us, it should be good for the customer.